The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 4th chapter, text 24 through 34, given by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in July of 1966 in New York.
Brahma hiva tena gantabham brahma karma samadhina. This verse we had been discussing in our last meeting about the sacrifice and there are different types of sacrifice recommended according to the different classes of men. There are generally three classes of human beings. Those who are under the influence of the modes of goodness, and those who are under the modes of passion. And those who are under the modes of ignorance. The whole Vedic scriptures, they are also divided into three divisions according to these modes of material nature. There are 18 Puranas. Puranas means supplementary to the Vedas. The Vedas, they are written in very difficult language. But in order to explain them to the ordinary person, there are Puranas, Mahabharata, Ramayana. The basic principle is described according to the modes of material nature. There are 18 Puranas. Out of that, 6 Puranas are in the modes of goodness, and the 6 Puranas are in the modes of passion, and 6 Puranas are in the modes of ignorance. So, there are different varieties of sacrifices according to the different class of men. The whole idea of Vedic literature is to give chance to every human being to develop a spiritual consciousness under certain rules and regulations. So, what is applicable to the persons who are in the modes of ignorance, they are not applicable to the persons who are in the modes of goodness. Or those who are in the modes of passion, they are not applicable to the modes of goodness. The gradual process of evolution. Now, just like there are recommendations that of animal sacrifice, there are many different kinds of sacrifice. There is a recommendation of animal sacrifice also in the Vedic literature. And what is that? That is a sort of restriction to the animal eater. Indirectly, it is restriction, but it is sanctioned also as sacrifice in the Vedas. Just like the Vedic principle says that if you want to eat flesh, don't eat flesh as it is not offered in the sacrifice. It is not offered in the sacrifice. Now, those who have been in India, perhaps you have seen the goddess Kali. The goddess Kali, before the goddess Kali, a goat sacrifice is and copper. But the basic principle says that if you want to take place, then you must sacrifice the god before the goddess Kali, and then you can take. And that prescription is also very difficult, because on the dark moon night, the goat has to be sacrificed, and there are so many paraphernalia, and the mantra, the hymn chanted there, the goat is, and to whisper within the ear that the man who is sacrificing you, he will be responsible for your life, and for yourself, you are going to get the next life as human being, without waiting for the evolutionary process. The animals, that there is an evolutionary process that is accepted in Darwin's theory also, anthropomorphism, anthropology, yes, not anthropomorphism, anthropology. Anthropology, there is evolutionary process, so that is accepted in the basic literature also. So, the animal which is sacrificed, he gets immediately his evolutionary process developed, promoted to animal, from animal life to human life. But the man who is offering that sacrifice, he becomes responsible. These are the, therefore, there are so many hints in the basic literature. The whole idea is that by offering such sacrifice, man is restricted from pleasure. Similarly, there are many kinds of sacrifices. They are described here. I think those descriptions may not be very elaborately described, but I give you the idea. Devameva parijagdhan yogina paripasate brahmagnava parijagdhan jagde naiva upadruhati. Sutradinindriyani anne samyavagnesi druhati sabdadin vishananna indriyagnesi druhati. Jagdabdana tapakriya jagdabdana tapakriya natajyam kattamaya kattabham. This is stated in the Bhagavad Gita that yagya, sacrifice, charity, dana, yagya, dana and tapa. Tapa. Tapa means penance. Now, there are four divisions of human society according to Vedic literature. The brahmachari, the grihastha, the vanaprastha and the sannyasa. The brahmachari means the student life, more or less, student life. And grihastha means those who are leading family life, after the student life. And vanaprastha means retired life. And the sannyas means renounced order. There are no connection with worldly activities. So these are four different stages of human social order. Now, the brahmachari, they are meant for sacrifice, the students. The students are recommended to sacrifice, especially to sacrifice sense gratification. The students are, formerly, they were in the Guru Griha, spiritual master place, and they had to undergo serious type of regulation. So, the brahmachari is expected to go to every householder and beg. There was no system of schooling, there was no system for payment. The spiritual master, the teacher, he did not accept any payment in counseling sense. That was not accepted. Because mostly the Brahmins, they used to become the teacher. So they were not accepting any salary. The Brahmins had forbidden to accept any salary. So the education was free. To every student, education was free. And village to village, education was free. So, in former days, even 50 years before, I think in villages, there were some small school, and all the village boys, they were coming and they were taking education. So education was very much widespread because education was free in this way. So students were meant to go for begging alms for the teacher. These are some of the regulated principles. Now, that is sacrifice. They sacrifice their labor for the spiritual master, for the teacher. And whatever they got, they surrender to the teacher. And it is said that after cooking, if the teacher asks the student, "My dear boy, you come and take your meal," then he will say. Otherwise, if the teacher forgets to call him one day for his meal, then he should not go and ask the teacher that, "I am not taking my food, give me my food." Rather, he should starve. So much penance, so much humility. These are called sacrifices. So the student life is meant for sacrifice. They should undergo a training under serious regulations and penances so that life may be a filter for future hope and future spiritual realization. That's the sacrifice is meant for the student life. Similarly, the family life. Those are yoga dana. Dana means charity. The grihastha, those who are living in family life with wife and children, they are expected to give in charity as much as possible. That is also charity. Suppose you are earning $1,000 in a month. So according to basic instruction, you should give in charity 50% of your income. $500 you should give in charity. And 25% you should spend for your family. And 25% as you are a family man, you may have it as bank balance so that in case of emergency you may require it. This is the practice. Suppose you are earning $1,000 a month, you should give in charity for God's service 50%. And 25% you should spend for your family dependence, and 25% you may have in a bank balance so that So yajna dana, this is also sacrifice. Sacrifice. So yajna dana and tapa. Tapa means penance. So the students are meant for sacrifice, and the grihasthas, the householders are meant for giving in charity. And so far we are concerned, just like sannyasi, we are meant for tapasya, penance. Oh, we should undergo all kinds of difficulties for spreading the knowledge that we are acquired. That is the class of sannyasi. A sannyasi, a renounced order of man who is in the renounced order of life, his business is that his acquired knowledge, his experienced knowledge should be distributed to the public. So according to the Varnasrama Dharma, the brahmachari and the vanaprastha and the sannyasi. Now suppose if there are 100% in a society, 25% students, 25% retired life, and 25% sannyasi, in a young sort of life. Now out of 100%, 75% they are engaged in the service of the Supreme Lord. The rest 25% who are grihasthas, they are meant for sacrificing 50% of their income for these 75%. That is the whole program of Varnasrama Dharma. That is a kind of spiritual community. Spiritual community. For spiritual advancement of the society, the whole social order is so arranged that 75% of the people, they are engaged in the matter of spiritual advancement of knowledge, and 25% of the population, those who are earning, those who are in a family life, those who have got factories, business and so many things, they should sacrifice 50% of their income for these 75% persons who are engaged in spiritual ministry. So that is the whole program. Oh, I'm very glad to see. That is the whole program of Varna Sambhava. Varna and Asa. Varna means that you have perhaps passed the caste system in India. That is called Varna. So the caste system which is now going on, that is a vitiated form of caste system. And you have heard in the Bhagavad Gita that Chakut Varnam Maya system Gunakarma Vibhava. This Varna and Ashram is also creation of the Supreme Lord Krishna. That is not man-made. So, how that Varna Ashram is created? Now, Gunakarma Vibhava. The Guna, as I have already told you, that we are being controlled in three qualities or three modes of nature. So, anyone, he must be either under the spell of these three qualities. So according to the quality and according to the karma, the varnas are there. I have several times explained to you. So the varna and the ashrama. Ashrama means the brahmachari ashram, the grihastha ashram, the manaprastha ashram and the sannyasa ashram. Ashram, this very word, indicates that it is spiritual. And perhaps most of you know that ashram means, ashram, this very word means that this place, just like temple or shop, there are so many buildings on the second avenue. When you see a church or a temple, you at once understand that this building is meant for spiritual understanding. Similarly, when we call ashram, ashram means that and it is a function, is meant for spiritual reality. So all the four classes of social order, the brahmachari, the grihastha, and the manaprastha, and the sannyasa, they are called ashram. Ashram means they are meant for a spiritual emancipation. The student is also given instruction so that before entering family life, he gets complete instruction of spiritual life. So that when he enters into family life, he is not just like a cat and dog. So for sense gratification, they are meant for, although they live with wife and children, they are meant for spiritual emancipation. This is called ashram, grihastha ashram. So that was the idea. The whole program was aiming at spiritual emancipation. Nati vidur sartha gati nahi Vishnu. Nati vidur sartha gati nahi Vishnu. Durasaya ji bahiratha manina. Andha gathan bhi rupaniya mana. Teti satanta urdani bhatha. It is a verse from Srimad Bhagavatam that Prahlad Maharaj, there is a statement of Prahlad Maharaj before his father was very much materialistic, so he was explaining to his father, my dear father, nothing vidu sartha gatim hi Vishnu. Genuine people, because he was in the materialistic family, his father was a great materialistic, so he is explaining, and he was a great devotee. The son was a great devotee, and the father was a great material, and there was a quarrel between father and son. So, father questioned, where you have got all this nonsense knowledge of spiritual? So he was explained, Nati vidu sartha gatim hi Vishnu, durasaya ji bahiratha manina. My dear father, these people, these materialistic people, that means men of your nature, they do not know what is their self-interest. Everyone is very busy for fulfilling his self-interest. But actually he does not know what is his self-interest. The self-interest is Vishnu. So go back to Godhead. That is self-interest. Self-realization, self-interest, and so many things. Everything is meant for going back to God. That is service. So Pallarman said that because people are very much illusioned by this external energy, the material energy is called external energy. Because people are deluded by this external, by the glamour of this external energy, they have forgotten that their self-interest is Vishnu, or the Supreme Personality of God. And they are conducting their life, general process of life, in a manner how the andhagathandhai rupaniyamana, just like one blind man is leading several other blind men. He is a leader. A blind man has become the leader of several other blind. So what benefit is there? If the man is blind, how can he live? That because blind, why blind? The andhagathandhai rupaniyamana, they isatantra urudami baddha. Isatantra means by the laws of God or by the laws of nature, they are bound up at tight hand and feet, and they are trying to get free from the control of the nature. So this struggle for existence is going on. Because they do not know that their self-interest lies in the understanding of his relationship with the Supreme Law. And that is also confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita. Bhavanam janmanavante janavan mala prapadvati. After many, many births, when a man is actually in full knowledge, he surrenders unto me, the Lord says. That is the ultimate insight. That is the ultimate knowledge that one should understand his relationship with Vishnu and surrender there. That is, Monam Janmanam Ante, after many, many births. Janava, who has actually acquired knowledge, he surrenders unto me, the Lord says. But Mahatma Sudhullava, but such a great soul is very rare. The surrender soul, a man in Krishna consciousness, a man surrendered to the control of the Supreme Lord, is very rare. So these are instructions we get from Devi Gita. And to come to this point, this surrendering process, that Vasudeva Sarvamiti, Samhatma Sudullava, to understand that the Supreme Lord is everything. Whatever is manifested before us, the different varieties of energies of the Supreme Lord, that is also stated in Vishnu Purana. एकदेशस्थितशार्णे ज्योत्नाविस्तारिणा यथा परस्य ब्रह्मणस्पति सर्वेदम् अखिलम् जगत् रे विष्णुपुराणे जस्ट लाइक फायर इज सिचुएटेड इन वन प्लेस एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूट इज हीट एंड लाइट एंड इल्यूमिनेशन फ्रॉम दैट प्लेस सिमिलरली whatever we are experiencing in this manifested world, they are different energies of the Brahman, Parasa Brahman, Parasa Parabrahma, that means Sri Krishna. Sri Krishna is the one. So, whole process is satisfied means that we have to reach to that one. The whole process of satisfied, either by yoga system, or by jnana system, or by observing the rules and regulations of the the social system, everything is meant for reaching to that point. What is that? Bhavanam janmanam ante janavanam to surrender and to the Supreme Personality of God. So, if we are intelligent enough, then we should consider that if I have to do this job after many, many births, I am getting myself to very much experience. And Lord Krishna says that this is the last point of knowledge. Why not accept it immediately? Why not accept immediately? If I have to come to Krishna at the last stage of mature knowledge and surrender unto Him, then Why should I wait for many births? Why should I wait for many births? Let me surrender unto me. Just yesterday night, one of our friends inquired that how long it takes time to have complete Krishna consciousness. So I replied that the Krishna consciousness can take place in a second, and it may not take in thousands of years. Because this point is here, that after all, we have to come to this point, that surrender unto Krishna, Vasudeva Sarvamiti. Vasudeva means Krishna. Krishna is everything. And therefore, I surrender unto him. Some Mahatma together do it. That person, a great soul, is very rare to be found. Therefore, why not become that great soul immediately by surrender unto Krishna? This is the point. By sacrifice. Sacrifice means you have to come to that point. Now, if that is the point to achieve at the end, then why not become immediately Jnanavan and surrender unto Krishna? That is my suggestion. Karmani Indriyani Karmani Prana Karmani Chapare Atma Sangyo Jugaano Juruhati Jnana Vritito. Atma Sangyo, there are different kinds of penances when it's called Atma Sangyo. The yogi principle is also another part of Atma Sangyo. Dravya-yajna, tapo-yajna, yoga-yajna, tathapare, sadhara, jnana-yajna, jatayar, sam-sutabhrita. There is dravya-maya-yajna. Dravya-maya-yajna means giving in charity. That is called dravya-maya-yajna. Jnana-maya-yajna means to engage oneself into the studies of the Vedas very critically, nicely. That is called jnana-maya-yajna. And those who are controlling the senses, that is called yoga-maya-yajna. So there are different kinds of yajna. And according to different kinds of yajna, there are different kinds of yogi also. Each one of them is called yogi. So according to the types of yajna, there are different kinds of yogi. Just like we are trying in the process of transcendental loving service. So we are bhakta yogi. We are called yogi in the devotional sense. Of course, we find in the sixth chapter that bhakta yogi is a topmost yogi. Yogi namati sarvesha madgata antarasana siddhavad bhajati yuman sani dhuttatamo mata. And that is stated by the law that there are different kinds of yogi. But the person who is always under the contemplation of me, he is the highest yogi. Therefore, devotional service, loving devotional service of the Supreme Lord, that is the topmost kind of yogi. That is, we find in every word, in every chapter, in every verse of this Bhagavad Gita, that Krishna consciousness that which we are trying to culture, that is the highest type of yoga. अपाने जुभति प्राणं प्राणोपानं तथा परे प्राणोपानगति निरुद्ध्या प्राणायाम अपरायना अपरे नियत आहारा प्राणा प्राणी सुजुभति. This fact, apart, there are breathing control, there are different kinds of air passing within the body and the yoga system, the controlling. That is also another kind of sacrifice. सर्वपेदे योग विद्या योग खपित कल्मषा yugdhāsiṣṭa mito bhujo jānti dhamma sanātana. Now, what is the purpose of this sacrifice? Now, it is concluded here. Sarvapi ete yagda vidyā. All these different kinds of yagda, they are meant for diminishing our sinful reaction. Our sinful reaction. Because we are accumulating many sinful reactions in different births. So, if we perform sacrifice, if we perform yoga, that process helps us in diminishing our accumulated sinful reaction. But so far, this harinama is a kevala. This is the easiest and the most, I am to say, supreme process As we have discussed many times, the Lord Chaitanya recommends the Chetadarpana Marginam. By this, Purang Vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtan, by this performance of Sankirtan, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, immediately the dust from the mind is clear. That is recommended. So, in spite of, it is very easy process. It is a supreme process. It's a process. All kinds of other yoga and yoga system. Nayam loka asti ajagnasya kutanna kurusattama. The Lord says that those who are not performing yoga, they cannot be happy even in this world, in this life. And what to speak on next life? This is the concept. That's all. We have to perform sacrifice. Nayam loka. I am a loka. I am in this world in which we are at present. That is also become more miserable. At the present moment, people are feeling so much painful in the modern existence because this process of yoga has been completely, people are engaged, work hard, earn money, and be engaged in sensual activities. This is the whole problem at the present moment is going on. That cannot bring any peace and prosperity to the society. We have to perform yoga. That is the natural law. The Lord says, Nayana Lokasi Ajagna, those who are not performing, for them, there is no happiness even in this world, even in this life. And Kuta Anna Purusattama, my dear Arjuna, then what to speak of the next life? Next life is still more miserable. Evam Bahuda Jagna Vidita Brahmano Mukhe, Karmajan Viditam Sarvani Evam Jnatar Mukhasi, Sriyana Dhrubhamaya Jagnat Jnana Jagka Parantapa, Sarvam Karma Sinam Kartho Jnani Puri Samapate. Now Krishna is concluding his different types of yoga. He says that Sriyana Dhrubhamaya Jagnat Jnana Jagka Parantapa. Jnana yoga means this is Jnana yoga, which we are doing here. We are discussing Bhagavad Gita very scrutinizingly and trying to understand every verse in reference to the Vedic reference and as far as our logic and argument goes. So this is called Jnana yoga. And Dhrubhamaya yoga means that yesterday we discussed that in the altar of fire we have to sacrifice clarified butter, grain, or sometimes animal sacrifice. They are called Dhrubhamaya yoga. So Krishna says, Sriyam Dhrubhamaya yoga, that Dhrubhamaya, that sacrificing goods or other things in the yoga. From that type of yoga, Sriyam Dhrubhamaya yoga, Jnana yoga patanta. Jnana yoga is a philosophical discussion, logical discussion of the aim of life. From authorized books like Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, if we have discussion, this is called Jnanamaya yoga. With knowledge, Jnanamaya yoga. So why Jnanamaya yoga is preferred? Sarva karma akhilam prakto jnani puri samapta. Because after all, we have to acquire that knowledge which will make me a surrendered soul to the Supreme. That Bhavanam Janmanamanta Jnanvan Prabhupadate. So Jnana also means that to understand our position, to understand what is God, to understand what is our relationship with God, to understand why you are in this material world, and what is our next life, where from we have come, where we have to derive knowledge, you can understand all these things. And when you understand everything, say, and the path is clear, you can clearly understand that I am the part and parcel of the Supreme. Therefore, my duty is to render transcendental service to the Supreme. That is the highest yoga, highest jnana. Knowledge. The Krishna advises that Gyanamaya Yudha, sacrifice. Now, to understand these things, we have to sacrifice some time, we have to sacrifice some labor, some attention. So these sacrifices are counted more than when we offer sacrifice of goods in the past. That is clearly stated. Now, what is the process of this knowledge? That is also stated by the law. Tadvidhi pranipatena priprasnena sivaya upadakshanti te jnanam jnanina satya darshana. Now, if you have to acquire knowledge, then first of all, you have to find out a person who has already seen the light. Tatta means, in the Srimad Bhagavatam, tatta is described, the English translation is absolute truth. That is called tatta. Now, varantita tatta vida satyam jadjana madhyam brahmeti paramatmeti bhagavaneti tatta. Now that absolute truth is known in three different stages. What is that? Brahma, Paramatma, and Bhagavan. So, if first we have to easily, really seeking knowledge, then we have to find out a person who is Tattva Darshana. Tattva has understood the absolute truth. Now, the absolute truth is realized in three phases. Brahma, Paramatma, and Bhagavan. There are certain Tattvavis, or the knower of the absolute truth, who understand the absolute truth as impersonal Brahma. And there are other knower of the absolute truth who understand the absolute truth as a localized super soul. These are called yogis. And the first mentioned person, they are called jnanis. And there are other tattvavis and knower of the absolute truth who knows the absolute truth as Krishna, the Supreme Personality of God. So, either Brahma or Paramatma or Krishna, the Supreme Personality, there is no difference. The same thing. But according to the capacity of the knower, they are, manifested into different stages. We have several times discussed this point, just like to understand the sun. Somebody is studying the sun ray. He is also studying sun. And somebody is studying what is the sun disk. So he is also studying sun. And somebody is trying to enter into the sun planet to see who is there. So everything is the sun. But the person who is studying the sun sign, their grade is lower than the person who is trying to understand the sun disk. And their position is lower grade than the person who wants to enter into the sun. So these bhaktas, they are trying to see the sun god within the sun. Just like they want to see Krishna. In the Upanishad we find there is a prayer that the Brahma is praying, "Will you kindly push off your gearing, dazzling gear, so that I can really see you." So within the Brahma Jyoti, there is Krishna. So we have to see that. So anyway, either the Brahmavadi or Paramatavadi or the Bhakta, they are all Tattvavis. They are all transcendental. There is no difference. But as there are three classes in every sphere, so there are three classes in the transcendental field also. So here Bhagavad Gita, the Lord recommends the Jnanina Tattva Darshana. You have to find out a person who is Tattva Darshi, who has realized the absolute truth, either in Brahma conception or in Paramatma conception or in Personality of God conception. Because we have got different shapes. The Paramatma, or the Supreme, absolute truth, is also manifested in three phases. Brahma, Paramatma, Bhagavan. So anyway, either you select the impersonal Brahma conception of the absolute truth, either you select the localized supreme soul, super soul conception of the absolute truth, or to accept the highest, the supreme personality of God as Sri Krishna. Matta paratara nanna tasthiti uchidasthi dhananya. The Lord says that this is the last phase of the absolute truth, what I have, Krishna. So anyway, we have to, if we want jnana, because the jnana yoga is recommended the highest yoga. So if we actually want jnana, then we have to first of all find out a person who is Tattva Purusha. Just like if you have to purchase gold, you must know where gold is evident. If you go for purchasing gold to a grocer's shop, then it is hopeless. It is not possible. Then you will be cheated. So at least you have to find out the person who has that kind of form, just like by culture. That is called satisfaction, jnana. If you are actually in search of knowledge, Krishna will help you. Because he is helping you in every way. Ishvara. Sadvasthakaham hirishanna vishwa. This we have discussed this morning. He is always with you. So he understands what kind of knowledge you are in search after. So if we must be sincere that we want to know that absolute truth, then you will find out. Krishna will help you. If you want a Brahmavadi, he will help you. If you want a Paramatmavadi, then he will help you. And if you want a devotee, that also helps. So that means you have to first of all search out a person. Krishna recommends that if you want knowledge, then first of all, that is the process, the whole Vedic process. In the Kathopa Upanishad also, it is said that tatvijnanartham gurumeva avivacchet. If you want to understand the transcendental science, then you have to approach the spiritual master. Who is spiritual master? Oh, nowadays everyone wants to be spiritual master. Oh, that is also mentioned. Who is spiritual? Samitpani Sutriyam Brahmanistam. You have to approach the spiritual master who is Sutriyam and Brahmanistam. Sutriyam means who has come down from the disciplic succession, from the Supreme. Just like we have understood in the fourth chapter, in the beginning of the fourth chapter, Evam Parampara Prapanyam Rajasayavir. There is a parampara, there is disciplic succession. So one is coming into that disciplic succession. And by coming from that disciplic successor, he is firmly convinced in the absolute. He is firmly conversant in the absolute truth. He is good. Two qualifications. He must come from that disciplic succession and he must be convinced. Nobody can deviate him from the conviction of the absolute. Any kind. These two qualifications. Sadvidhi Panipatena Paripasne. The Kathopanishad says, Tadvijnanartha Grooming Avigat. This is a Sanskrit grammatical injection. When there is a question of imperative, you must, there beginning, this form of heart is used, that then you must go. You don't think that without going to a qualified, bona fide spiritual master you can have. No, that is not possible. Here also, Lord Krishna also recommends that with the pranipatena paripasena seva. If you want to learn the transcendental fact, then you have to find out a transcendentalist, that's the point. That is as recommended Tattva Purusha. In Bhagavata also, it is said, tasmat gurum prapadveta jignasu seva uttama. One who is hankering after the highest type of question. We have got so many questions. We can question the whole day and night, what is the rate of this commodity, what is happening in this political game, what is going on in China, when are these questions are done. Not these questions. So Uttam, one who has become inquisitive in the Uttama. Uttama means Uttama Pava. There's not any question of pertaining to the material world. One who is eager to question about the absolute truth of the spiritual world, he requires a spiritual mind. does not groom for the bridge. The first Indian saying is that does not groom for the way, you must submit to your spiritual master. Who is the commander to find out a spiritual master? Tasmat Guru Vijnasu. Vijnasu means who is inquisitive. What kind of inquisitive? Vijnasu Se Uttama. What is the ultimate goal of my life? If you have no such view, to inquire what is the ultimate goal of your union, not required to search out a spiritual master. Spiritual master is not a showboat. Just like, so many people, they have got a spiritual master. Or let me have also some spiritual master. It is not like that. It is one of the jignasu. One must be very much inquisitive of the transcendental subject matter. He requires a spiritual master. So here also, Lord says, the Tadvidhi, if you want to understand the transcendental subject matter, then you must approach a person, a bona fide spiritual master. And the process is pranipat, pranipatena. Pranipat means full surrender. Pra means prakishta rupena, fully. And nipat means completely becoming a blank slate. Blank. Nobody should approach a bona fide spiritual master just to argue with him and just to with a desire that I can see what kind of spiritual master. No, this is you. You have to select a spiritual master. My Guru Maharaj, my spiritual master used to say that you have to select a spiritual master not by seeing, but by your ear, but by hearing. You don't select a spiritual master who has got a very good ear or beard or some very beautiful teacher. Oh, he's a very good, nice looking. No, you must hear. Tadvidhi panipatena. Suti, the whole process is suti. The Vedas are called suti. And the ear has the oral instruction. So here, also the same thing recommended by Lord Krishna. The 25th, first of all, you have to find out a bona fide spiritual master, and then you should surrender unto him. This is the first process. Pranipatena, pariprasana. Pariprasana means sincere inquiry. Not only surrender, you must be intelligent enough to inquire. not that just when something is hard and there is no question. No, there must be some question. Pariprasana and sivara. So, surrender, inquiry and seva, service. We sing this song every day. Yasya prasadat bhagavat prasadat, yasya prasadat nagati tukopi, dhyayam shivam tasya jasasya sannam, bambi gurasri charanavadanya. Yasya, if we actually find a spiritual master, bona fide spiritual master, and if we can make him satisfied by my service, then my path for realization of God is guaranteed. This is the thing. Yes. First of all, we have to find out a bona fide spiritual master. Then, by my service, by my surrender, by my questions, if we utilize, then my path for back to Godhead, back to home, is guaranteed. That is it. Very important verse. Tadvidhi panipatena paripasana sikriya upadakshanti te jnanam. That knowledge by which you can go to the point of your self-interest, Vishnu, that knowledge you can realize. Thank you.